Welcome back, dear viewers. And to shed more light on the consultation and innovation and digital transformation, we're joined over the phone by Dr. Nizar Sami, consultant, innovation and digital transformation. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. How are you? Thank you very much.
How are you, sir? Sir, what's the significance of holding the Arab Sustainable Development Week in Cairo, in your opinion?
First of all, I'd like to congratulate everybody about the Arab League selection of Egypt to host this version or this season from the Arab Sustainable Development Week. As we all know that since 2015, when the United Nations issued or established the Sustainable Development Goals, the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, and Egypt took this these goals into high priority and high level of consideration and mapped that into the vision of Egypt 2030, as well as the strategic goals for Egypt right now to move to 2030 from being one of those emerging economies. In this direction, and having the Arab League in Egypt or in Cairo, given all the successes that have been developed, went through Egypt for the last period, that became like a competitive edge where the leadership of the country reflected and showed that the importance of the sustainable development on all levels, either from the environmental sustainability or economical sustainability or even social sustainability. All these three dimensions are of high importance for the Egyptian leadership. Therefore, it's highly important, getting back the soft power of Egypt, that we are there, we are taking all the consideration, we are in the global worldwide interest, and we put these things into on table and giving the role model for the Arab countries to follow such initiatives and such plans that we already developed in Egypt for the last period.
Right. Well, sir, in your opinion, what are the main challenges facing the UN Sustainable Development Goals in the Middle East and the Arab world?
Good question. If we look for those dimensions, the 17th goal for the Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations, the first place, it needs a sense of leadership. So commitment, dedication, and leadership are two things, the most important part. Then following this or implementing this in a vision where everybody in the country understands, everybody can see where do we go, where we are heading for the next period. All these things are the main challenges. And the third part, which is the implementation. Can the different organizations or the or companies or even government entities provide, can they provide programs or lists of projects that will be able to direct this in that direction? For instance, if we took the energy per se, so how about sustainable energy? How about renewable energy? If we took the water, one of those, it's more challenging part, which is access to water and having clean water. So is there any initiatives coming from that? So it is from top to toes, from the top of the pyramid, where the leadership of the country tells the very basic needs of everybody in the society. They have to understand, they have to be, they see the vision, as well as accommodating all the resources, and of course the access to funds where we can be able to implement such programs.
Right. Well, sir, what's the impact of investing in people through training programs on digital transformation?
Yes. It's the game of nations right now, the digital transformation, because the human capital is the most important part. All these programs, all these initiatives, all these projects where we are advocating digital transformation and automation and all these things, the main purpose of these things is to the well-being or make the people more happy and to ease their lives and creating wealth. In this direction, raising awareness for the community is extremely important. For instance, if we are talking about financial inclusion per se, and moving from the informal sector to a formal sector, it needs awareness, it needs training, it needs orientation about the new systems where banks and financial institutions are developing solutions for the society. So at the end of the day, the manpower of the people are the key success factor for this. You can develop, the easiest part is to get computers, get servers, all these type of technology, you can put them in place. But if these devices or these systems cannot help people to achieve much, much a better scenario, a better situation, we will be in questioning the whole setup. Therefore, having like such a program, for instance, your this team program, then can give like a bite or
right.
Of educational and awareness sessions for the community to know about what's going on.
Right. Well, thank you very much, Dr. Nizar Sami, consultant of digital transformation, for your input. And moving on to the 28th edition of the Arab Music.